Okay, interview for Viz. Let's see how this goes. Because I'm on like take 12 here. Okay.
The comic book that really sticks out for me is Gotham by Gaslight, when Batman was alive in the 1800s and fighting Jack the Ripper. That issue kind of showed me that it doesn't matter what you can and can't draw, there's no real wrong or right way to draw anything.
Once I opened up those pages, I knew that someday I would love to see our characters alive in a comic book.
My favorite thing of all time was on Sundays getting the big, giant Calvin and Hobbes by Bill Watterson strip that was in the back. I would save these comics, I would trace them, I would do everything I could to try and learn how to make a world of my own like Bill Watterson did with Calvin and Hobbes.
The comic that made me want to be a comic book artist was the original run of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles that Mirage published, that Eastman Laird did. That's when I realized one person or a small number of people could tell a story that was on par with any big budget motion picture.
The Far Side had such a big effect on me. I really developed this crazy kind of off-the-wall sense of humor because of The Far Side.
I first realized I love comics in, I guess, the late 80s when three things happened at once. I really got into Archie comics, Calvin and Hobbes started, and I really got into Batman.
Esto es Madrid, la ciudad en la que vivo. Y este de aquí es mi traductor.
I am the official translator.
Me voy a por ella.
I loved comic books ever since I was a little kid, but I started to crave them ever since I was around 12 years old, when I stumbled upon a hidden treasure, a Spanish magazine called Zimak.
Zimak?
Zimak?
Comic.
Comic.
I really grew up drawing constantly, all the time. The little funny drawings that you see in all of our books and in the Uglydoll material, that's just the way I've drawn since I was a tiny kid.
It's so fantastic that you can take these crazy characters and just kind of push them together and really do whatever you want with them. There's something about comics, there's something about the way they're presented and the way you can read it and keep going back to that and see these isolated moments in time that I just absolutely love.
The best advice I can give about making comics is to start making them now. And even if you think they're bad, it's all right, because you're only going to get better.
If that's something you're into, go for it. And it's going to be hard, and it's going to be a really long, tough road, but it's completely worth it in the end.
Don't even really try to follow what others do. You're just going to end up behind someone who's already made a path. You kind of have to make your own path.
I love being able to come home every day and think to myself, like, this is my job. This is what I do. I get to draw. Hi, my name is Phil. I'm from Dallas, Texas. I'm slapping my hands, so I'm going to start that over.
Without comics today, I really don't know what I'd be doing. I'd probably be a lot more buff.
Falta la mame. La mame. Falta la mame.
An utterly bizarre creature, if I may say.